Chico! His eyes flicker open, slowly, halfway. Chico, it's us! Then his mouth opens, but no words come out. He wets his lips and tries again.
It's Daniela.
His voice barely above a whisper. Daniela! He nods. We take seats near the bed.
Was that your drag name?
He nods again, then closes his eyes. Jorge mouths.
Say something.
I look down at the bundle of bones lying on the bed, all that's left of our friend. So, Chico, I say, trying to sound cheerful but close to tears. When did you start doing drag? There's a pause, then his eyes gradually flicker open again.
16.
16?
Uh-huh.
He attempts to take a deep breath.
I put my first dress on at 16.
Wow, you were an early starter.
Hairdressing in the day and drag at night. And the drag just took over.
There's a soap playing on the TV fixed to the wall. Chico stares at it. The sound's turned down, but he looks at peace, as if reminiscing. Jorge looks across at me to continue. What kind of drag was it, Chico?
Oh, merciful drag, honey.
He replies, more animated now, as if he's slowly coming back to life.
It was merciful. We had eye sequins, makeup, serious makeup, glamour makeup.
I bet all the men were after you.
Oh, child. They were sniffing round my pussy like hotcakes.
All you needed was maple syrup.
And butter.
We all laugh. The mood in the room suddenly lighter. Then Jorge grabs a pillow from the end of the bed and places it behind Chico's head.
Those were the days, honey.
Chico sighs as he rests his head back.
All gone now. All we wanted to be was Miss Continental.
You entered Miss Continental?
Oh, yeah. We had to do interview, swimwear, talent, evening gown, and then the finalists got an onstage question, and that's when it all took off.
A skeletal hand reaches out for Jorge's hand.
Oh, I was doing all the shows back then, honey. Oh, yes. Turn round. Because you had to have the backdrops. You couldn't just come out on stage like Pretty Miss Lulu. No way. You had to lick ass for a year to get those sponsors. And then, once you were signed, you had to work it. And I'd rise out of that floor with dances and outfits and lights streaming. And then I'd step down and I'd sing my little black ass off.
He starts to sing quietly.
Do you know where you're going
to?
Do
you know where you're going to? Do you like the things that life is showing you? Where are you going to? Do you know? Do you get what you're hoping for?
Where was this, Chico?
What?
Where was this?
Oh, all over, honey. The Fontainebleau in Miami Beach, La Cajun Fall in Chicago, Copa in Fort Lauderdale, San Antonio, Parliament House. 3 shows a night, 6 night a week, and it was hard, honey. All those rehearsals, and the choreographer would hit me on the leg with a stick, and she'd say, 1, 2, 3, 4, Daniela. Because that was my name back then, Daniela. She'd say, can't you fucking count, Queen? She made me feel like such an idiot. And I think, of course I can fucking count, bitch. But I just kept missing that darn 4-step. That was always my problem, that darn 4-step.
Were you on your own?
Oh, no, sugar. There was a few of us. But those Cuban drag queens, law, they could be vicious. They put visine in your drink so you get diarrhea on stage.
His head moved slowly in my direction.
Say, are you taking notes?
Yes. You don't mind, do you?
Write it all down, honey. Just keep on writing till I stop breathing.
I smile warmly. So when did you start doing Dinah Ross?
Mahogany onwards. When Mahogany came out, I never looked back. I painted my nails, and I was Miss Ross when I stepped out of the car, and Dorothy Dandridge when I opened the hotel door. Sometimes Whitney, off-season, or Donna Summer for holidays, but otherwise it was Miss Ross 24/7.
He reaches towards his protein drink on the side table, takes a sip with a trembling hand.
Oh, I lived in drag, honey. For 25 years, I even traveled in drag. In the later years, I was pretty much living my whole life as Miss Ross. I had trunks full of dresses. I remember one time I went through customs as Miss Ross, and I had all the bags around me, and this big old butch guard said, "Where you going, girl?" And I said, "I'm moving to the UK, Big Daddy."
You moved over here dressed as Dinah Ross?
Of course, child.
To be with Ian?
We met on holiday, and that was it. I just packed my pantyhose and moved right on over. I remember on our wedding night, he said, "I can't believe I've married a drag queen." And I said, "Well, you married a good one, so shut the fuck up."
He takes another sip of his drink, and his eyes move toward the ceiling.
I just hope he's waiting up there for me.
Then the mood in the room drops.
You know what? My sisters flew over last week, and they didn't even wait.
He leaves the sentence unfinished, although it's clear what was meant.
And they took Ian's ring. I left it on the table over there, and they just took it. It's the only thing of his I had left. I've been real upset about that.
Jorge, sensing the change in the mood, tries to keep the conversation upbeat.
So, when did you stop, Chico?
Stop being Miss Ross. My last Miss Ross was a memorial for a friend, as a favor for a friend who died of AIDS. After that, I could never do Miss Ross again. She died that night and she never came back.
He leans back on the pillow.
Honey.
Yes?
Before you go, could you write a letter for me?
Sure.
It's to Maz.
I find a clean page in my notebook. Okay, fire away. He coughs, a dry, racking cough that appears to set him. Jorge holds a glass of water to his lips, and he takes two sips. Then he tries to take a deep breath again and continues. But now his voice is wavering, fading to barely a whisper.
Dear Maz, thank you for your letters. I'm so sorry I haven't written back. It's been very difficult for me to motivate my hands or speak correctly, and that is the reason I haven't written. As soon as I get better, I will return your letters. Clayton and Jorge came to visit me today, and they were able to write this letter for me. I love you, baby. You hang in there, and take care, and don't forget me. Just because I don't write, don't mean I don't care. Love you dearly. Chico. P.S. Please don't forget me.